Hi, this is John from PSDDude, and in this video I would like to show you a WordPress plugin that makes it very easy to design graphs directly in your WordPress posts and pages. You can get this WordPress plugin on Code Canyon by following the link that I posted in the description of this video. Let's see what this plugin can do. As you can see, this plugin allows you to create several types of graphs in your WordPress posts or pages, including pie charts, donut charts, bar charts, stacked bar charts, line charts, and a special kind of charts which creates charts from images. In this video, I will only go into detail on how to use this plugin to create pie charts and donuts. Let's see what this plugin can do. For this, I've set up a demo environment which is freely accessible. I'm logging in with the demo credentials and then I'm taken to the WordPress dashboard. This plugin allows me to add charts and graphs to posts or pages. Let's create a new post. The plugin added a new button in the edit post screen. This button will allow me to add charts inside the posts. Let's create a post. I will call it "Pie charts are delicious." All right. And then let's say I want to add a new pie chart. I click on the button and I get this screen. This screen allows me to add several types of charts, but as I mentioned, in this video I'll only go into detail on how to add pie charts and donuts. So let's leave it at this. This plugin is a visual designer for charts and graphs. The visual designer has two parts. It has a preview part on the left hand side of the screen and it has a settings part on the right hand side of the screen. The preview allows me to view in real time the changes that I'm making to the settings. Also, you'll notice here that I have a control for choosing the zoom level at which I'm previewing the chart, and I can use this to better see the chart in case the chart goes over the size of the screen. In the settings side, the settings are grouped into three categories: general settings, text settings, and data. Let's see the general settings. As you can see, I have here the size of the chart, which I can change by changing the width and height. Let's say I want to make the chart 400 by 400. As you can see, immediately in the preview part, the chart changed. Alright, then I have padding. I can say I want 20 pixels padding, and you can see that the padding around the chart has changed. Also, I can choose the type of chart, whether it's a pie chart or a donut. Let's make it a pie chart. Next setting is a start angle. The start angle allows me to set where the pie chart will start drawing the slices in the pie chart. Let's say I want a minus 90 degree start angle. Next, there's the highlight mode. There are three highlight modes that I can set for the pie chart. One is the default highlight mode, and you can see that this default highlight mode means that when I go with my mouse over a slice, the slice slightly changes color. There's also the pop highlight mode, which pops each slice while I go with my mouse over it. And there's the border. The border will draw a small border next to the slice that I'm currently hovering with my mouse. I can also change this size, the size of the border, by modifying it here. And you can see that the border is now thicker. Let's leave it at 4 pixels. Next, let's take a look at the text settings. The text settings allows me to change the settings of the text present in the pie chart. So for example, fonts are set now to sans serif, 16 pixels and white. Let's change this. Because my theme includes some web fonts, the Open Sans fonts, I can also use this here. So let's say I want Open Sans. And as you can see, immediately the change is reflected in the preview part. I can also use Open Sans Light because they're a bit thinner, so it looks a bit better. The size of the font I can also change here. Let's make it a little larger. Let's say I want to make it 20. And I can change the color of the fonts. I will leave it white for now. Next setting is the decimal settings. This allows me to decide how many decimals the numbers on the pie chart will have. If I need 2 decimals, it will be 2. If I don't need any decimals, I will leave it at 0. The label type can be either percent, value, or none. The percent is pretty obvious what it does. Value will display the actual value behind the pie chart data. I can also choose none, and then I don't have any labels on the slices. Let's leave it at value. The last category of the settings are data. This is perhaps the most important part of the settings, because here you decide the actual data that the chart will display. For example, you have unit name. This decides the label behind each slice. So for example, I can put here sales. And as you can see, the chart immediately changed. Then you have the numerical data, which is grouped into slices. And you have the name of the slice, and then the value and the color. Okay, so for the name of the slice, let's say that I want to display the sales for my products on Code Canyon. So let's say I have here charts and graphs, visual design. And let's say I have 25 sales. Then let's say I have library. I'll leave it at 35. And then I have others. And I'll leave it at 50. I can also add new slices by pressing the Add Slice button, or I can remove slices. Right. Changing the name of the slices is reflected again immediately in the chart. So you can see in the tooltip that the tooltip displays that I have 25 sales for Charts and Graph Visual Designer, which is 23% of the entire amount. I can also change the colors for the slices simply by clicking on the color and then choosing a color or setting a color from the color picker. I'll just choose one predefined color also for the next slice, and the same for the last slice. And that's it. This is our first pie chart. Now all I have to do is click insert and the chart will become part of my post. That wasn't too difficult, was it? So now let's see how this post looks like on the preview. As you can see, I have the post and the pie chart interactive with all the settings that I've chosen in the edit mode. Let's go back. Let's say I change my mind and I don't want this to be a pie chart, I want it to be a donut. I just click on it, edit, and in the general settings I can switch to donut and then click insert again. And now let's preview it. And it's a donut chart. Good. Usually posts have text, so let's see how text would integrate with this chart. So I'm putting in some lorem ipsum text. Let's add also a title. Chart title. I'll make it a heading 2. And let's say I want this chart to be aligned to the right. Okay. And then I want to move it inside the text. Maybe a bit higher. All right. So as you can see, I integrated the chart inside the text, so it looks more natural here, like this. Let's preview it. And it looks pretty good. All right, let's add some more lorem ipsum text. And then preview again. And it looks very good. Let's see what other types of charts I can add to this post. First, I will add some text. And then let's say I want to insert a pie chart here. Let's say I want to make it a pie chart. And I'll leave the rest as they are. I go to text settings. And say I don't want to display any label. And then to data. And let's add some more slices. And then let's change the colors. And let's add one more slice. All right. Let's adjust a bit the values to be more even. And let's delete this slice. Alright, and just click insert, and as you can see, the chart is inserted where I chose to insert it. Now if I click preview, the chart is inside the post. So we have our donut chart or pie chart, and there's one more type of chart that you can create using the pie chart section of this plugin. Let me show you how to do that. So I'll go to the end and again click to add a new chart. I leave it at donut, and I go directly to the data area. Now, if I remove all the slices except one, then what I'm left with is this single value donut chart, which displays percent like this. I can choose a neutral color for the background, and I can also change a bit the text color to make it more visible. Let's choose black. Open Sans for the fonts, light maybe, and I make it a bit bigger to be more visible. I'll get rid of the decimals. And let's go into the general settings and change a bit the start angle. I'll let it at -180. And as you can see, I can modify the value from 0 to 100, and it will show me exactly the slice from the total exactly according to the value that I set here. And then I click insert, and the chart looks like this. Let's align it on the center of the screen, and if I click preview, the chart is inserted in the post as you expected. I hope you enjoyed this video and decide to buy the Charts and Graphs WordPress Visual Designer. If you have any questions or suggestions, don't hesitate to leave a comment and I will try to reply as soon as possible. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't miss the videos that I will make showing the other types of charts and graphs that you can make using this plugin.